Imagine transforming your product's reach and user experience by simply embracing inclusiveness. Accessibility isn't just a box to tick. It's a strategic advantage that opens doors to innovation and benefits every user. In today's episode, we'll reveal how inclusive design can elevate your offerings and set you apart in the market. Welcome to Right Decisions, a series where we help you navigate through tough business choices using powerful visualizations of your data. Did you know that 1.3 billion people worldwide experience significant disabilities? That's 16% of the global population, making them the world's largest minority. This isn't just a statistic. It's a massive audience waiting to be engaged through accessible design. Accessibility is not just a moral duty, but a legal requirement across Europe, the United States, or Canada. For example, Target, a US retail chain, faced one of the highest penalties for website inaccessibility. Their website lacked features like alt text and keyboard navigation, making it unusable for blind users. They were sued for violating the Americans with Disabilities Act and settled for $6 million to affected users, plus $3.7 million in legal fees. Watch on to discover how to stay compliant, boost accessibility, and grow your product's audience.
According to the World Health Organization, disability is no longer viewed as a purely medical issue. It's a complex phenomenon that reflects the interaction between a person's body and the features of the society in which they live. These mismatches can be permanent, such as vision loss caused by cataracts, temporary, like sight problems caused by an injury, or situational, such as when bright sunlight makes your screen unreadable. All these scenarios benefit from the same inclusive design and accessibility solutions. Inclusive design is an umbrella approach for creating products and experiences that are usable by as many people as possible. By intentionally considering diverse abilities, language barriers, gender, age, and other human differences from the very beginning of the design process. Accessibility is a key part of inclusive design. It focuses on removing barriers that prevent people with disabilities from fully using digital products, ensuring they can perceive, navigate, and interact with content just like any other user.
And how do principles of diversity translate into business benefits? By adopting inclusive design, you not only create products that are accessible to everyone, but you also tap into a larger market. This means reaching a broader audience, increasing customer satisfaction, and ultimately driving higher engagement and loyalty. Features like keyboard navigation enhance the experience for all users, including developers and power users, making your product more intuitive and enjoyable. By focusing on inclusivity, you're not just doing what's socially responsible. You're making a smart business decision that can lead to increased market share and a stronger brand reputation. Implementing accessibility might appear more straightforward for applications like news portals or e-commerce sites, as they have well-trodden paths and best practices to follow. But what about more unconventional products like diagrams or data visualization tools? You might find yourself pondering several critical questions, such as where to start collecting information on accessibility. Should I first conduct research to understand which users with what challenges are using my solution? Is there a universal set of guidelines to follow? Let's have Anna answer these questions.
To ensure your product is inclusive, start by following the latest version of the Web Content Accessibility Guidelines, the universal standard for accessible design. Remember that each case is unique and requires careful consideration, especially for unconventional products, like diagrams. To help you get started, we've prepared a checklist based on WCAG 2.1 guidelines. You can download it from the link in the description. Now, you might wonder if you should research the specific disabilities of your users before upgrading your app. The short answer is no. Everyone has a right to privacy, and that includes their medical history. Also, impairments can be temporary or situational, so you never know when and where a certain accommodation might be needed. Keep in mind that accessibility improvements often lead to a better user experience for everyone. Think of the curb cut effect. Features designed for a specific group, like curb cuts for wheelchair users, often benefit a much wider audience, like people with strollers or luggage. So by focusing on accessibility, you're ultimately improving the experience for everyone.
Let's explore how accessibility works in practice with a project we did for a client in the educational media sector. They needed to revamp their internal diagramic tool to make it accessible for users of all abilities. We started with discovery workshops to align business goals and accessibility needs. Then we moved into designing the user experience with a strong focus on meeting WCAG 2.1 standards. Our teams work closely, constantly refining features to ensure everyone could use the tool effectively. In the end, the client received a fully accessible, high-performing workflow builder that greatly expanded their user base.
This Synergy Codes project is a great example of how to implement accessibility. Keyboard navigation was a key focus, ensuring that all interactions, like navigating notes or editing properties, could be done without a mouse. The application includes ARIA, Accessible Rich Internet Applications, attributes to support screen readers. ARIA is a set of special HTML attributes that help screen readers understand and interact with complex parts of a website, providing real-time feedback as users work with the diagram. For improved navigation, especially in large diagrams, the application features a minimap and a dynamic search box, allowing users to quickly find elements and understand the context. High contrast color schemes, logical focus states, and shortcuts like WSAD and F2 are also included to enhance speed for both power users and those with motor impairments. These elements worked together to create a tool that's inclusive without sacrificing functionality or performance. This project is an example of adding accessibility to a product that already existed. However, if you're building a new application, it's good practice to start for inclusive design from the beginning. It's much easier and also more cost-effective to build these features from the ground up than to integrate them into a project later on.
Accessibility isn't just about compliance or ticking boxes. It's about creating better products, reaching a wider audience, and ultimately building a more inclusive world. Whether you're working on a brand new application or improving an existing one, remember that planning for accessibility from the start is always the best approach. And to help you get started, don't forget to download our WCAG 2.1 based checklist. It's a great resource for ensuring your projects are accessible and user-friendly for everyone. See you in the next episode of Right Decisions.